Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to BANKERSADDA. Today we are going to discuss reasoning quiz for IBPS exam 2019, 25th February. So today is day 33 of Kar IBPS 2019 FATEH. So now move to question number first. Direction 1 to 5. In this question, relationship between different elements is shown in the statement. These statements are followed by two conclusions. जैसे कि inequality based question है, हमारे को एक sum statements given है, उसके बाद दो conclusion given है. उसको हमें बताना है कि which of the these conclusion follow and which doesn't. So if we talk about the statements, n equal to p, p is less than equal to f, f is greater than equal to l, and l equal to k. Now move to the conclusions. The first conclusion is f equal to k. If we consider both the variables f and k, there is a relation between them of greater than equal to. So the first conclusion is false and the second one is also false, because in second one it is given that f is greater than k. But agar hum dekhe to isme hamara either or ka case lag raha hai, kyunki dono mein variable same hai aur jo relation hai wo greater than equal to ka hai. To iska jo right answer hoga wo hoga option c, either conclusion one or conclusion second follows. Now move to the next question. Next question may be jo hamare conclusion first hai usme pucha j is greater than t. Agar hum dekhe to j is greater than m and m is greater than t, to first conclusion wala follow kar raha hai. Ab baat kare second conclusion ki, to in second conclusion z is greater than j, but between both the variables there are opposite sign of greater than and less than. So there is no certain relationship between these two variables. So ये हमारा जो conclusion है ये false होगा. तो जो इसका right answer होगा वो होगा option A, only conclusion first follows. Now move to question number third. Question number third में हमारे sum statements given है. तो पहले इन्हें combine कर लेते हैं. C is greater than equal to G, G is greater than equal to Q, Q is greater than equal to R. Then it is given that J is greater than equal to C and Q equal to Z. So अगर जो हमारी final statement deduce होगी, अब देखते हैं conclusion क्या है. तो जो हमारा first conclusion given है उसमें हमारे से पूछा है G is greater than equal to Z. अगर हम देखें G और Z के बीच में relation, तो G जो है greater than equal to Q है and Q equal to Z है. तो जो हमारा first conclusion है वो valid होगा. और अगर हम बात करें second conclusion की, C greater than equal to R, तो C और R के बीच में सेम एक ही सिंबल है greater than equal to का, तो second conclusion भी हमारा valid होगा. Then इसका हमारा जो right option होगा वो होगा option E, both conclusion first and second follow. Now move to question number four. Question number four में अगर हम देखें conclusion first, तो उसमें हमारे से पूछा है E is greater than C. अगर हम E और C के बीच में symbols देखें तो opposite sign आ रहे हैं हमारे. तो अपोजिट साइन जब भी आते हैं तो उन दोनों वेरिएबल के बीच में कोई डायरेक्ट रिलेशन हम फाइंड नहीं कर पाते. तो इसका जो ये हमारा कंक्लूजन फॉल्स होगा. नाउ मूव टू सेकंड कंक्लूजन. इन सेकंड कंक्लूजन इन्होंने हमसे पूछा है वेदर एफ इज ग्रेटर देन बी और नॉट. तो जो एफ और बी के बीच में अगर देखे तो इन दोनों के बीच में भी अपोजिट साइन आ रहे हैं. एफ इज लेस देन ई, ई इज लेस देन डी, एंड डी इज ग्रेटर देन सी, एंड सी इज लेस देन बी. तो अपोजिट साइन आ रहे हैं. सो देयर इज नो सर्टेन रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन देम. तो ये भी हमारा कंक्लूजन फॉल्स होगा. देन द राइट ऑप्शन फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन इज ऑप्शन डी, नीदर कंक्लूजन वन नॉर कंक्लूजन सेकंड फॉलो. नाउ मूव टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर फाइव. क्वेश्चन नंबर फाइव में भी हमारे को मल्टीपल स्टेटमेंट्स गिवन है. सो हम इसको इन स्टेटमेंट्स को कंबाइन करते हैं. पहले तो हमें गिवन है एल इज ग्रेटर देन के, के इज ग्रेटर देन एम, एम इज ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू एन, एंड एन इज ग्रेटर देन ओ. नाउ मूव टू कंक्लूजन फर्स्ट. O is less than M. अगर O और M की बात करें तो जो O है वो less than N है and N less than equal to M है. तो ये जो हमारा relation first है ये हमारा true होगा. अगर हम बात करें second conclusion की, तो second conclusion में हमारे से पूछा O is less than K. तो जो O है और K इन दोनों के बीच में same symbol है, same set का symbol है, और उसमें less than symbol है और less than equal to है, तो इसका भी relation हमारा valid होगा. That is O is less than K. तो जो इसका राइट ऑप्शन होगा वो होगा ऑप्शन ई, बोथ द कंक्लूजन आर ट्रू. Now move to direction 6 to 10. In each of the questions below are given three statements followed by two conclusions, numbered first and second. You have to take the given statement to be true if they seem to be at variance from commonly known facts. Read all the conclusion and then decide which of the given conclusion logically follows from the given statement, disregarding commonly known facts. Give answer. So, jo hamara jisme question number 6 hai, usme hume statement given hai, some debit or credit. Jo some debit hai, wo credit hai. Then hume given hai, all credit are cashless and all cashless are online. Now move to conclusion first. So in conclusion first, it is given that some online are debit. So agar hum dekhen, some online are debit. So some credit are debit tha and all credit are cashless and all cashless are online. So some jo debit hai, jo credit tha, wo online bhi hoga. So jo conclusion first hai, wo valid hoga. Agar ab baat kare conclusion second ki, to second mein humse pucha hai, some credits are online. Kyunki second hai, all credit are online. So sare ke sare credit cashless the aur sare cashless hamare online the. So ye bhi hamara conclusion valid hoga. Then iska jo right answer ho jayega, wo ho jayega option E. Both conclusion first and second follow. Now move to question number 7. Question number 7 mein humare ko statement given hai, some Paytm are Flipkart. Jo some Paytm hai, they are Flipkart. And some Flipkart are Amazon. And then it is given that all Amazon are shop close. Agar hum conclusion ki baat karein, to first conclusion humare se pucha hai, some shop close are Flipkart. To jo some Flipkart are Amazon the aur all Amazon are shop close. To jo hamare Amazon shop Flipkart hai, wo hamara shop close bhi honge. To ye hamara follow karega. अब बात करते हैं सेकंड कंक्लूजन की, सम अमेज़न और पेटीएम. तो जो सम अमेज़न और पेटीएम के बीच में कोई रिलेशन नहीं दिख रहा वेन डायग्राम में, तो ये हमारा कांट से होगा. इसके बारे में हम कुछ नहीं कह सकते. तो इसका जो राइट आंसर होगा वो होगा ऑप्शन ए, कंक्लूजन ओनली कंक्लूजन फर्स्ट फॉलोज. नाउ मूव टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 8. क्वेश्चन नंबर 8 में हमें स्टेटमेंट गिवन है, ऑल रिंग्स आर बस. जो सारे के सारे रिंग है वो बस है. देन हमें गिवन है सम बस आर मैश एंड नो मैश इज स्टार. तो हमारा फाइनल वेन डायग्राम आ चुका है. अब बात करें कंक्लूजन की, तो जो कंक्लूजन फर्स्ट में वहां से इन्होंने पूछा है सम स्टार आर रिंग. तो स्टार और रिंग के बीच में कोई डायरेक्ट रिलेशन नहीं है, तो इन दोनों के बीच में कोई कांट से रिलेशन होगा. देन हमें जो सेकेंड है उसमें पूछा है नो स्टार इज रिंग. तो स्टार और रिंग के बीच में कोई नो का भी डायरेक्ट रिलेशन नहीं है, हमें सीधा वेन डायग्राम से दिख रहा है. तो ये भी हमारा फॉलो नहीं करेगा, कांट से होगा ये भी. बट अगर हम देखें तो सम और नो के बीच में एक इधर और का केस बनता है जब वेरिएबल सेम हो या पैरेलल में हो, पैरेलल में हो या क्रॉस हो. तो जो इसका राइट आंसर होगा वो होगा ऑप्शन सी, इधर कंक्लूजन फर्स्ट और कंक्लूजन सेकेंड फॉलो. नाउ मूव टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 9. क्वेश्चन नंबर 9 में हमारे को स्टेटमेंट गिवन है सम कार आर रेल. देन हमें गिवन है सम रेल आर हेलीकॉप्टर एंड सम हेलीकॉप्टर आर शिप. अगर अब हम कंक्लूजन देखें तो जो कंक्लूजन फर्स्ट हमारा से पूछा है वो है सम कार आर हेलीकॉप्टर. एंड वी कैन डायरेक्टली सी दैट देयर इज नो डायरेक्ट रिलेशन बिटवीन कार एंड हेलीकॉप्टर, सो दिस कंक्लूजन कैन नॉट बी फॉलोड. तो ये कांट से रहेगा हमारी तरफ से. अगर हम सेकंड की बात करें तो सेकंड में हमारे इन्होंने कंक्लूजन पूछा है सम रेल्स आर शिप. जो सम रेल और शिप के बीच में भी हमें कोई रिलेशन नहीं दिख रहा, तो ये भी कांट से होगा. तो जो इसका राइट आंसर होगा वो होगा ऑप्शन डी, नीदर कंक्लूजन वन नॉर कंक्लूजन सेकंड फॉलो. नाउ मूव टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 10. क्वेश्चन नंबर 10 में हमें स्टेटमेंट गिवन है सम नोट्स आर चिलर. जो सम नोट है दे आर चिलर एंड ऑल चिलर आर मेटेलिक. देन इट इज गिवन दैट नो मेटेलिक इज लिंक. Now move to the conclusion. The first conclusion is some nodes are link. If we see relation between node and link, so there is no direct relation of sum between node and link. So ये जो हमारा conclusion होगा ये कांट से होगा. अगर हम second conclusion की बात करें तो second conclusion है हमारा सम metallic are nodes. तो जो हमारे सब nodes chiller थे और सारे के सारे chiller metallic थे, तो जो chiller nodes हैं वो metallic भी होंगे. तो सब metallic are nodes ये हमारा follow करेगा. तो इसका जो right answer होगा 10th का वो होगा option B, only conclusion second follows. Now move to direction 11 to 13. There are 9 members X, E, L, F, S, K, N, W, N, T in a family of 3 generation. 3 generation ki hamari family hai. Uske baad hame isme given hai. S is father of W. Jo S hai, wo father of W hai. Who is sister of T? Jo ki sister hai T ki. Then hame given hai X is mother of F. जो X है वो मदर है F की. Who is brother in law of K? वो K का brother in law है. Then हमें given है there is only 2 married couple, कि इनों में इन दोनों में खाली इस generation में 3 generation है और 2 married couple है. अगर हम next statement देखें तो next statement हमें given है X is sister in law of L. जो X है वो सिस्टर इन लो है एल की. तो हमारे जो दोनों मैरिड कपल है वो मिल गए. देन हमारे को इसमें गिवन है के इज आंट ऑफ एन. जो के है वो एन की आंट है, तो के का जेंडर पता चल जाएगा और एन पता चल जाएगा. एन यहाँ आएगा या फिर एन यहाँ आएगा. देन इसमें हमें गिवन है एन इज एन हु इज चाइल्ड ऑफ एफ. तो एन जो है वो एफ का चाइल्ड है. देन हमें गिवन है L इज आंट ऑफ S. जो L है वो आंट ऑफ S है, तो S हमारा इससे आएगा कि जो S है वो मैरिड टू K है. S मैरिड टू K है, तो S इसमें मेल हो जाएगा. एंड S के दो चाइल्ड हैं, दैट इज W एंड T. देन इसमें हमें गिवन है S हु हैज ओनली वन सन. S का एक सन है, तो T इसमें मेल होगा. वन सेकेंड थर्ड फोर फाइव सिक्स सेवन एट नाइन. तो हमारा 9 के 9% डिफाइन हो गए. देन हमें लास्ट में गिवन है एक्स हैज ओनली 2 चाइल्ड. जो एक्स है उसके दोनों उसके खाली 2 ही चाइल्ड है. तो अगर एक्स के 2 चाइल्ड हैं तो इसमें एफ और एस तो 2 ही चाइल्ड हैं इसमें. देन अगर हम लास्ट पर्सन देखें तो लास्ट पर्सन जो हमारा रह गया वो था ई. अगर हम अब एक चीज और देखें, जो एक्स थी एक्स मदर इन ऑफ एफ. Who is brother-in-law X? X is sister-in-law of L. तो X sister-in-law of L है, तो जो X होगा वो married होगा E से, और जो E है E brother of L हो जाएगा. और L हमारे को aunt given था. So जो हमारा final diagram है वो deduce हो जाएगा. अगर हम बात करें क्वेश्चंस की, तो क्वेश्चन इसमें वहां से पूछा इन्होंने, क्वेश्चन नंबर 11, इसमें वहां से पूछा हाउ इज ई रिलेटेड विद रिस्पेक्ट टू के. ई का रिलेशन पूछा है के से. तो जो ई है वो फादर ऑफ के है, तो ऑप्शन बी फादर इसका राइट आंसर होगा. ई फादर इन लॉ है. ई फादर तो एस का है, जबकि के मैरिड टू एस है, तो ई फादर इन लॉ हो जाएगा. दैट इज ऑप्शन डी. तो ऑप्शन डी इसका राइट आंसर होगा. Now move to question number 12. Question number 12 में हमारे से पूछा इन्होंने if y is wife of n, जो y है वो n की वाइफ है. अगर y n की वाइफ है तो n उसका हस्बैंड हो जाएगा. देन हाउ इज n रिलेटेड टू x? तो जो x है वो n उसका ग्रैंडसन हो जाएगा. तो ऑप्शन सी ग्रैंडसन इसका राइट आंसर होगा. Now move to question number 13. Question number 13 में हमारे से गिव पूछा इन्होंने If the age of S is 48 years, अगर S की age 48 year है, then what could be the most possible age of T? तो जो S के जो child है T, तो जो T की age होगी वो लेस देन एस तो होगी होगी, तो जो अगर हम देखें 48 से कम है, 48 से कम खाली इसमें ऑप्शन डी है, दैट इज 24 ईयर्स, तो ऑप्शन डी इसका राइट आंसर होगा। नाउ मूव टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, डायरेक्शन 14 to 15, स्टडी द इन्फॉर्मेशन केयरफुली एंड आंसर द क्वेश्चंस गिवन बिलो। ए स्टार्टेड वॉकिंग टुवर्ड्स साउथ नॉर्थ डायरेक्शन, जो ए है वो नॉर्थ डायरेक्शन की तरफ चलना शुरू करा, एंड आफ्टर वॉकिंग 7 मीटर ही रीच एट पॉइंट बी, देन टेक अ राइट टर्न एंड रीच पॉइंट सी आफ्टर वॉकिंग 5 किलोमीटर 5 मीटर, देन इसके बाद हमें गिवन है फ्रॉम देयर ही टेक्स अ लेफ्ट टर्न एंड वॉक आफ्टर वॉकिंग 5 मीटर, तो यहाँ से भी 5 मीटर ऊपर गया, तो यहाँ से ये जो है वो डी पॉइंट पे पहुंच गया। देन हमें गिवन है एंड अगेन टेक अ लेफ्ट टर्न आफ्टर वॉकिंग 7 मीटर, देन उसके बाद उसने 7 मीटर लेफ्ट टर्न के बाद 7 मीटर मूव करा, फाइनली ही रीच एट पॉइंट ई। तो अगर हम बात करें तो जो क्वेश्चन नंबर 14 है उसमें वहां से इन्होंने पूछा व्हाट इज द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन ई एंड बी, अगर हम ई और बी का डिस्टेंस निकाल लेते हैं तो पाइथागोरस थ्योरम से आएगा हमारा, अगर ये 5 है बी और सी, तो जो ई और जो ई डैश है ये 2 मीटर होगा, और जो ई ई डैश और बी है ये 5 मीटर होगा, तो जो इसका डिस्टेंस निकलेगा वो आएगा 5 का स्क्वायर + 2 का स्क्वायर, डेट इज √29 मीटर। तो इसका मतलब इसमें जो तो इसका मतलब जो ऑप्शन डी है वो इसका राइट आंसर होगा। अगर हम बात करें तो इसका जो ऑप्शन डी है वो राइट आंसर होगा, ऑप्शन सी √29 इसका राइट आंसर होगा। अगर हम बात करें क्वेश्चन नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन की, तो जो नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन है उसमें हमारे से इन्होंने पूछा है क्वेश्चन नंबर 15 में हमारे से इन्होंने पूछा है इन विच डायरेक्शन इज पॉइंट ए विद रिस्पेक्ट टू ई, तो ई के रिस्पेक्ट में ए पूछा है, तो जो ए है वो साउथ ईस्ट होगा, तो जो उसमें जो इसका राइट आंसर हो जाएगा वो हो जाएगा ऑप्शन ई नन ऑफ दिस, क्योंकि साउथ ईस्ट हमें मेंशन ही नहीं है किसी भी ऑप्शन में, तो जो ऑप्शन ई है वो इसका राइट आंसर होगा। सो दैट्स ऑल फॉर टुडे, थैंक यू एवरीवन।
हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू bankersadda.com। टुडे इज द डे 33 फॉर द 6 month preparation plan कर IBPS 2019 FATEH। This is a preparation plan for IBPS exams of 2019. Today is 25th of February and the topic for today's quiz is word usage. This is a new pattern introduced in almost every 2018 exams of bank or insurance. So this is a very important topic. Let's start. Directions 1 to 15. In each of the following questions, a word has been used in the sentences in 3 different ways. Assimilate जैसे word है, ये 3 sentences में use किया गया है. Choose the option corresponding to the sentence in which the usage of the word is correct. अब आपको ये ध्यान से देखना है कि correct पूछा है या incorrect. तो अभी आपको बताना है जिसमें correct है. Let's start. Assimilate. Assimilate का मतलब क्या होता है? Absorb और integrate. People, ideas or culture into a society. ठीक है? Let's see. It took time for them to assimilate into American political culture. ठीक है? Absorb करना उस culture को. The national capital to absorb capacity to absorb and assimilate newcomers will remain powerful. ये भी ठीक है? Please dial the assimilate number or 0 for the operator. Absorb number तो कुछ नहीं होता. तो option हो जाएगा. Both 1 and 2 are correct. Next. नेक्स्ट इज एग्जॉल्ट। एग्जॉल्ट का मतलब होता है थिंक और स्पीक वेरी हाईली ऑफ समथिंग, या फिर एक तरीके से प्रेस करना समवन या समथिंग। वी लव इट, वी एग्जॉल्ट इट, वी चेरिश इट। ठीक है। As a parent, I always look for a job that offers the exalt of on-site childcare. Exalt यहाँ incorrect है. For a fee, most celebrities will exalt a product, यानी praise a product by pretending to like it. Okay, so 1 and 3 are correct. Next, exonerate. Exonerate का मतलब होता है किसी को absolve कर लेना from blame for a fault. Absolve from a fault या wrongdoing, ठीक है? He tried for the rest of his life to exonerate himself. ठीक है? Since I freak out about the smallest things, I exonerate my sister's gift of staying calm during stressful times. So exonerate यहाँ पर incorrect है. After the doctor helped me beat cancer, I started to greatly exonerate him. अगर help किया तो उसे exonerate करने का यहाँ कोई मतलब नहीं है. तो आपका answer हो जाएगा option A. नेक्स्ट है आपका chaos. Chaos का मतलब होता है कंप्लीट डिसऑर्डर या फिर कंफ्यूजन. ओके, देयर वाज अ लिटिल chaos, बट वी वर्कड थिंग्स आउट. एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. इफ यू डोंट एनफोर्स द रूल्स यू हैव chaos. ठीक है, द chaos इन हिज हाउस वाज स्टार्टिंग टू गेट हिम डाउन. तीनों में chaos करेक्ट है, तो आपका आंसर हो जाएगा ऑल आर करेक्ट. नेक्स्ट है बोल्स्टर. अब बोल्स्टर का क्या मतलब होता है? इसका मतलब होता है सपोर्ट करना किसी चीज को या स्ट्रेंथन करना. ओके, अ स्ट्रॉन्गर डॉलर वुड इन द लॉन्ग रन बोल्स्टर बॉन्ड प्राइसेस. ठीक है, सपोर्ट कर सकते हैं. आई विल बी हैप्पी टू बोल्स्टर यू फॉर एनी एक्सपेंसेस यू माइट हैव इनकर्ड. एक्सपेंसेस के लिए बोल्स्टर नहीं किया जाता है, रीपे या रीइंबर्स किया जा सकता है. He won't let me bolster him for the cost of his journey. There is no sense. Only option A is correct. Next. Next is emancipate. Emancipate. Emancipate का मतलब क्या होता है? Set free, especially from legal या फिर कोई social issues. ठीक है? तो even before slavery officially ended, my relatives made the decision to emancipate all their slaves so they could live freely, to set free. ठीक है? After the judge reviews the evidence, he will decide whether or not he wants to emancipate you by voiding your prison sentence. ठीक है? Tell me what you have spent and I will emancipate you. तो इसमें स्पेशली लीगली है वो होता है, तो टेल मी व्हाट यू हैव स्पेंट एंड आई विल इमेंसिपेट यू, ये यहाँ करेक्ट यूसेज नहीं है. आपका आंसर हो जाएगा बोथ 1 एंड 2. नाउ हियर वी हैव अ टेस्ट सीरीज. स्टूडेंट्स, अगर आप NIACL का एग्जाम देने वाले हैं, AO का फेज 2 आपका मार्च में है, 2nd of March, तो वेरी फ्यू डेज आर लेफ्ट. तो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू परचेज द टेस्ट सीरीज फॉर द सेम, you can purchase it from our store .adda247.com. you will get 25 total sets, 15 in which you will get 15 practice sets and 10 full length mocks. It is very important to practice full length tests before appearing for the original examinations. Okay, so now let's move to next question. Embolden. Embolden ka matlab hota hai kisi ko courage ya confidence dena. She made several emboldened references to the current financial situation. This is incorrect. Do you believe alcohol commercials embolden teens to drink? Embolden yani encourage. ठीक है. The loss will only embolden me to work harder to earn a medal in the next Olympics. Okay, it will encourage you, give me confidence. So both 2 and 3 are correct. 8. Apposite का मतलब होता है कोई चीज apt हो या perfect हो. The judgment is very apposite to the present case. ठीक है? Do you believe alcohol commercials apposite teens to drink? No. A few words about truthfulness and objectivity of this article are apposite. Apposite means apt. So both 2 and 3 are correct. Next, tarnish. Tarnish का मतलब क्या होता है? कोई luster lose कर देना अपना, या फिर किसी चीज का less valuable बन जाना. If you touch silver too much, you will make it tarnish, causing it to lose its luster and be less valuable. It is seedha theek hai. Wear cotton gloves when cleaning silver because the acid in your skin can tarnish the metal. Metal agar kharab hota hai, to hum uske liye tarnish use karte hain. It is correct. The actions of a few can tarnish the image. Image bhi tarnish ho sakti hai. Hai na? It can become less valuable. So this tarnish is absolutely correct in all the statements. Question 10, infuriate. Infuriate का मतलब होता है किसी को बहुत ज़्यादा angry या impatient कर देना, ठीक है? Pleading with her to calm down only seemed to infuriate her more. उसे और गुस्सा ही दिला रहा था वो, ठीक है? Even evidences of male chauvinism amongst her friends would infuriate her, ठीक है? The calming aloe vera plant is used by people all over the world to infuriate burns and skin irritations, ठीक है? ये buy होगा यहाँ पर. To infuriate burns and skin irritations. So what do we see? Ki aapka option D, yani both 1 and 2 are correct. Next, wanton. Wanton ka kya matlab hota hai? Wanton ka matlab hota hai of a cruel or violent action jo ki deliberate ho and unprovoked. Theek hai? So we will stop the wanton sale of school playing fields and ensure that sport takes its proper place within the curriculum. ठीक है, तो आपका वन करेक्ट है. As stated in the supplement, the heritage erosion is due to ignorance and not wanton destruction. This is also correct. The couple starter home was a wanton house. Wanton house नहीं होगा, with just enough space for the two of them. This is incorrect. That means one and two are correct. Okay, students, we have a new vacancy this time. Central Warehousing Corporation 2019 for the post of junior superintendent. इसमें क्या है, इसका पैटर्न जो है वो आपका बिल्कुल बैंक के एग्जाम्स की तरह है. सो इफ यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर बैंक एग्जाम्स, यू मस्ट डेफिनेटली ट्राई फॉर दिस. इसका आपको एक टेस्ट सीरीज मिलेगा जिसमें आपको कॉम्बो है प्रीलिम्स का भी प्लस मेंस. यू विल गेट 15 टोटल टेस्ट, जिसमें 10 प्रीलिम्स के फुल लेंथ टेस्ट और 5 मेंस के. यू गेट बोथ दीज इन सिंगल पैक. सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू परचेज दिस, go visit store.adda247.com and start with your preparations. Now moving towards the next question, addle. Addle means make someone unable to think clearly or feel confused kar dena. Let's see. Because our instructor was so unclear, I had to continually ask him to addle and repeat what he was saying. To addle nahi, confuse karne ko thoda na bolenge unhe. Is it true smoking marijuana can addle your brain and make it difficult for you to concentrate? Absolutely correct. When the test question started to addle my brain, my head began to hurt. Absolutely correct. Moving towards question 13. Grapple. Grapple ka matlab kisi cheez se difficulty se struggle karna. Theek hai? So that the women could obtain recipes every week, she would have to grapple to the chef's block. Incorrect. The inmate dreamt that one day he would be able to grapple himself from his unjust prison sentence. So, yahan par grapple bhi yahan par koi meaning nahi hai. You'll need to grapple with the dog if you want him to take his bath. Right. This is correct. You need to struggle with the dog. Question 14. Depose. Depose ka matlab hota hai kisi ko office se hata dena, kisi position se hata dena forcefully or suddenly. Let's see. Without hesitation, the ruler killed everyone who was linked to the attempt to depose him, to remove him. Correct. Did you fake an illness to depose sympathy from your ex-boyfriend? There is no point to depose sympathy. If Danielle gets a good grade on her math test, it will really depose her self-confidence. It's a misprint here. It should be in her math test. So here also it is meaningless. So answer will be option A. Moving towards the last question, tranquil. The doctor says I need to be in a tranquil place so I can relax. Tranquil kya hota hai? Calm. So theek hai. Since we were the only ones on the beach, we enjoyed a tranquil day. Fine. The yoga instructor will show us the best way to reach a tranquil state. This is also correct. That means all are correct. So that's all for today's session. Thank you and have a nice day.
Good afternoon, friends. Today we are going to discuss quantitative TTET quiz, which is based on previous year questions for IBPS. Okay, so today date 33 for CAR IBPS 2019 FATEH. So the topic is discussed previous year questions. Now we will move on questions. The first question is, A shopkeeper buys three articles for ₹2100. Cost price of each article is same. If he made overall profit of 20% on selling all the three articles, then find the profit obtained on selling one article. Okay. Here, total cost price is ₹2100. So cost price of each article will be 2100 divided by 3, that is 700. Okay, and overall profit is 20%. So profit on each article will be 20% of cost price of each article. This is 700. From here this will be 140. Okay, this is the profit earned on each article. And if you look at options, A will be the right option. Okay, now we will move on next question. Question number second. In the second question, three partners A, B and C together invested ₹6500 in a business for same period of time. Profit of A, B and C is ₹1440, ₹2160 and ₹2640 respectively. Find the total investment of A and B together. Okay, so investment ratio of A, B and C will be profit ratio. So profit is 1440, that is 1440, 2160 and 2640. Okay, so if we simplify this, this will be 6, 9 and 11. Okay, so this is the investment ratio of A, B and C. Now required amount or investments, sum of investments of A and B together. So this is A, this is B. So 6 plus 9, that is 15, divided by sum of ratios. So 15 in 11, 26 into total investment is 6500. So 6500. From here if we solve this, this will be ₹3750. Okay, here 13 is common, 2, this is 500, and again this is 250. Okay, so when we multiply 250 by 15, this will be 0, 5, 7, remainder 37. So 3750 will be the answer. And if you look at option B will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number third. In the third question, a boat running upstream takes 20 minutes to cover a distance of 12 km while it takes 22 minutes to cover a distance of 22 km in downstream. Find the speed of current. Okay, so downstream speed is, or upstream speed, V minus S, this is distance 12 km and time is 20 minutes. So in hours this will be 20 by 60, or we can say 12 upon 20 into 60, this will be 3. So 12 into 3 is 36 km per hour, okay, and downstream speed V plus S, distance is 22 kilometer and time is 22 minutes, so 22 into 60 in hours, okay, so this is 60 kilometer per hour. So speed of current will be speed of current, this will be 1 by 2 downstream speed minus upstream speed, so this is 60 minus 36, so this will 1 by 2 into 24, or we can say this is 12 kilometer per hour. So speed upstream is 12 kilometer per hour, and if you look at options, D will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number fourth. In the fourth question, 15 men can do a work in 12 days, 18 women can do the same work in 20 days. In how many days 8 men and 12 women can, together will complete the work? Okay, so here let efficiency of one man is M, and one woman is W. Okay, so 12 men can do in 12 days, so 15 men, okay, this is equal to 18 into 20 women. From here this is 180 and this is 360, or we can say efficiency of one man is twice the efficiency of one woman. Okay, so 8 men and 12 women means 8 into 2 women plus 12 women, this is the total work, and divided by efficiency of women, so efficiency of women is total work, and the total work in first case is 18 into 18 women into 20, okay, and let time taken by these women, 12 women and 16 women, is X. Okay, so this is the total work and this is also total work. So from here X will be 18 into 20, here 16 plus 12, so 16 plus 12 will be 28. Okay, so from here this is 18 into 2, 360 divided by 28, or we can say here 4 is common, so this is 90, and D, this is 7. Okay, so 90 by 7 days, this is the required answer. In complex fraction it can be written as 12 into 6 by 7 days. Okay, so this is the required answer, and if you look at options, D will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 5th. In the 5th question, a sum of money fetches rupees 240 as simple interest at the rate of 5% per annum after 6 years. What is that sum? So very easy question here, both required sum will be 240 simple interest into 100 divided by 5% into 6, so this is 40, or this will be 800. So this is the required sum, and C will be the right option. Okay, next section, second section. In the second section, directions from 6 to 10 is given as what will come in the place of question mark in the following number series. So here there are 5 number series questions from 6 to 10. Okay, so the question number 6th is 22, 26, 53, 69, 194 and question mark. These are the terms and we have to find the value of question mark. So the terms are 22, 26, 53, 69, 194 and question mark. Okay. So here if you see differences of the terms, consecutive terms, here 4 is the difference and here 13 minus 6 is 7 and 4 minus 2 is 27 and from here again if you see difference 9 minus 3 that is 6 and 6 minus 5 that is 1 and again 14 minus 9 5 and 8 minus 6 2 and 1. Okay, so this can be written as 2 to the power 2, this can be written as 3 to the power 3, this can be written as 4 to the power 2 and this can be written as 5 to the power 3. So next should be 6 to the power 2, that is 6 square, that is 36. So question mark will be 194 plus 36. This will be 64 10 and 93 12 and 1 13 1 remainder 112. So this is the required answer, that is D will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 7th. In the 7th question the terms are 4, 8, 24, 96, 480 and question mark. So here 4 into 2 will be 8, 8 into 3 will be 24, 24 into 4 will be 96 and 96 into 5 will be 480. So question mark will be 480 into 6, that is 288 0. This is the required answer and if you look at options we will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 8. The 8th question is 11, 15, 21, 29, 39 and question mark. The terms are 11, 11, 15, 21, 29, 39 and question mark. So here if you see differences, here difference is 4, here difference is 6, here difference is 8 and here difference is 10. So next should be 12. So value of question mark should be 39 plus 12, that is 51. Okay, so this should be the answer and if you look at options A will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 9th. In the 9th question the terms are 11, 14, 22, 40 and 73 and question mark. So the terms are 11, 14, 22, 40, 73 and question mark. Here difference is 3, difference is 8 and difference is again 18 and here difference is 33. Okay, again here difference is 5 and here difference is 10 and here difference is 18 plus 15, that is 33. So 15, these are the multiples of 5, 10, 15. So next should be 20. Okay, so here this should be 20 plus 33, that is 53. So value of question mark should be 73 plus 53, that is 126. Okay, this should be the answer and if you look at option C will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 10th. In the 10th question the terms are 112, 87, 67, 52, 42 and question mark. The terms are 112, 87, 67, 52, 42 and question mark. Okay, so here again if you see differences of the consecutive terms, here 112 minus 87 52, that is 25, and here 20, here difference 67 minus 52 51, that is minus 15, and here minus 10, so next should be minus 5, so value of question mark should be 42 minus 5, that is 37. Okay, so here E will be the right option. Okay, next question, or we can say next section. In the next section, third section, in the third section, directions from 11 to 15 is given as what should come in place of question mark in the following questions. Okay, so here there are five simplification problems from 11 to 15. Okay, now we will see the first question, that is question 11. 2 to the power 5 plus 2 to the power 10 is equal to question mark into 12. Okay, so the value of question mark will be what? So 2 to the power is 2 to the power 5 is 2 to the power 5 means 32. Okay, and 2 to the power 10, so 2 to the power 10 can be written as 2 to the power 5 means 32, and 2 to the power 10 can be written as 2 to the power 5 to the power 2 divided by 12. So here this is 32 and this is 32 to the power 2, that is 1024 divided by 12. Okay, so this is 6, 4 to 6 and 3 to 5 and 1, 0 divided by 12. If we solve this, this will be 8, double 8. Okay, here 4 is common, so this is 3, 2, 2 remainder, 2, 5, so this is 6, and again 4. Okay, so again 3 is common, so this is 8 and 8. So 88 will be the right answer, and if you look at options, D will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 12th. In the 12th question, square root of 256 plus square root of 784 is equal to question mark into square root of 121. So this is the square of 16, this is the square of 784 is the square of 28, and 121 is the square of 11. Okay, so this is 16 plus 28 is equal to question mark into 11. So 684 and this is 4 divided by 11 question mark, so value of question mark will be 4, that is A will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 13. Question mark plus 5 by 2 plus 1 into 1 by 4 is equal to 1 into 1 by 8 plus 2 into 5 by 2 plus 7 into 1 by 4. So here question mark, and 1 into 1 by 8 can be written as 9 by 8 plus 2 into 2 plus 5, that is 9 by 2 plus 7 into 4, 28 plus 1, 29 by 4 minus these terms 5 by 2 minus 4 into 1 plus 1, that is 5 by 4. Okay, so this is 9 by 2, 5 by 2, so this can be written as 4 by 2, that is 2. So 9 by 8 plus 2, and here 29 minus 5, that is 24, so 24 by 4, that is 6. Okay, so this is 2 plus 6, 8, and 1, 9. So 9 into 1 by 8, this is the required answer. or we can write this 9 into 8 72 and 1 73. So 73 upon 8, this is the right answer. Okay, so if you look at options, B will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 14th. In the 14th question, 115% of 360 plus 180% of 270 is equal to question mark into 225. So question mark into 225, this is 115, that is 115 upon 100 into 360 plus 180 upon 100 into 270. Okay, so here this is cancelled, and here 2, this is 23, this is 18. Okay, so 18 is common in both, so 18 into 23 plus 27, so this is 50, and 50 into 18 900. Okay, this is 900, and this is equal to question mark into 225, so value of question mark will be 900 divided by 225. Okay, so here if you divide this by 225, the value will be 4. Okay, because 4 into 5 20 0 remainder 2, 4 into 2 8 and 2 0 remainder 1, and 4 into 2 8 1 9. So 4 will be the right option, that is option E. Okay, so ये सिंप्लीफिकेशन का है कि मतलब इजी फार्मूला है, इस तरीके से सॉल्व करना. बहुत से स्टूडेंट ऐसा करेंगे, डायरेक्ट इसको मल्टीप्लाई कर देंगे और इसको इसको मल्टीप्लाई कर देंगे, बट इट विल बी लिटिल बिट लेंदी. सो इफ यू, अगर आप इसमें से कॉमन ले सको 18 18, सेम टर्म इफ यू टेक कॉमन, देन 23 प्लस 27 विल बी 50, सो कैलकुलेशन विल बी ईजी. ओके, नाउ last question of this quiz, question number 15th. In the 15th question, 9 to the power question mark into 7 to 9 is equal to 3 to the power 4 into 9 to the power 6 divided by 81. So 9 to the power question mark into 729, we will convert all the terms in 9 to the power, so 9 to the power question mark, and 729 is the square of 27, or we can say is square, and this is 3 to the power 4 into 9 to the power 6 divided by 81 can be written as 3 to the power 4. Okay, so this is cancelled, 9 to the power question mark, this can be written as this can be written as 9 into 3, so 9 into 3, or we can say 3 to the power 6. Okay, and this can be written as 3 to the power 2 into 6, that is 12. So 9 to the power question mark will be 3 to the power 6, or we can say 9 to the power question mark can be written as 3 to the power 6 can be written as 9 to the power 2, 3 to the power 2, that is 9, and to the power 3. So the value of question mark will be 3. Okay, so the right option will be B. Okay, so this is the required answer, and this is the end of this quantitative aptitude quiz. I hope आप लोगों को पसंद आया होगा. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर लिसनिंग मी, एंड बेस्ट ऑफ लक फॉर योर एग्जाम्स.